hand I have a feather, in my right hand a hammer. And I guess one of the reasons we got here today was because of a gentleman named Galileo a long time ago, who made a rather significant discovery about falling objects in gravity fields. And we thought that where would be a better place to confirm his findings than on the moon. And so we thought we'd try it here for you. The feather happens to be appropriately a falcon feather for our falcon. And I'll drop the two of them here, and hopefully they'll hit the ground at the same time. How about that? Which proves that Mr. Galileo was correct in his findings.
Pretty great video, and of course, that's the Apollo 15 astronaut dropping a hammer and a feather on the moon, proving Galileo's theory that in the absence of atmosphere, objects will fall at the same rate, regardless of mass. Now, last year, we explored the journey from outer space to inner space, and today, the Galileo Prize goes to Matthew Putman and Nanotronics Imaging.
When I was young, I would joke that the silence kept me up at night. Even then, I knew it was my own mind that haunted me. Lying in bed, if I could focus on something small, something inconsequential, I might prove I too mattered, that I was not merely noise. But the smaller and deeper I dove, the more I walked away with questions. Every night was a crusade to prove simplicity, every morning a failure. Until eventually I looked forward to those nights alone. I was giving myself the freedom to explore. I knew I would never be happy to settle for today's answers. Those nights fueled my days.
Matthew Putman. Hi.
Hello.
Congratulations.
Well, thanks so much.
Do you know what I'm going to ask you about? Your eureka moment. I hear that it had something to do with some pot cookies. Or as my kids would say, no, mommy, it's weed. But anyway.
Oh, gosh. But, you know, I'm going to skirt the question of the pot cookies because... truthfully, I have sort of a strange relationship with Eureka and with Archimedes in general. While great discoveries do come from, you know, moments that you least expect, in my case, I'm not sure how great the discovery was, but it came when I was sick with cancer and I was lying on the sofa with only time to dream and to calculate, to think. And, you know, similarly, I think there is a fear associated with this. You know, Archimedes actually died at the hands of a Roman soldier because he didn't want to put down his instruments. So obsession and mortality and discovery and eureka, I think, go hand in hand. But I think it's the eureka moments that our team now at Nanotronics has every day that's much more important than any eureka moment I've had.
Well, congratulations, and we're so happy to see you here healthy.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you. Congratulations. Thanks.